Cue the fire, and just like that, billions and billions and billions of dollars gone or trapped.
On October 31st, the New Rural Cooperative Rural Capital Mutual Aid Society in Nohe City, Heilongjiang, reportedly collapsed. That locals had deposited billions of yuan, only to find that now the money was gone and the operators had disappeared.
An unprecedented number of smaller banks are now being absorbed into larger ones.
China's rural banking sector has been hit hard by Beijing's efforts to rein in.
Many financial institutions are failing. The CCP's financial system is crumbling. It's a scam targeting ordinary people.
Oh my gosh, that is frightening. But you want to know what's even more frightening? Is the censorship. I dare you to go try to find this story. You'll almost be like, I don't think it even exists, but you have all the video. Also, the good news, if you made it this far and you're watching me, that means we have not been deleted. Also, if you would like to get news that you cannot get anywhere else because they delete it, can you do me a favor? Hit the subscribe button or check and see that you've been unsubscribed by the beautiful Google. And if you think I am crazy, it is true. Also, in the next few days, you guys are gonna have to read in between the lines, because the media will be controlled. Also, in regards to controlled media, if you would like to know what my prediction is for the 2024 election, you're gonna have to make it through at least halfway through the video. I think what I will say will surprise you. Also, the bank that just failed, which, and a lot of them are in China, lots, but it's not getting out there. I know this because I got Chinese friends that are like, no, everything's controlled. And I said, thank goodness we do not have that in America. We have, okay, a privatization or private banks or quasi banks. Like you take a Rocket Mortgage, things like that. You're like, wow, they're really big. Oh, they're very big. And right now banks are not lending. It's a tightening cycle. They're not lending. So people are like, well, dang it, I gotta get a loan somewhere. So we have seen one of the largest growths of non-financial institution banks that we've ever seen. Look. Loans to shadow banks, that's what they call them. Ooh, that's scary. They're in the shadows. Why are they in the shadows? Well, that's because the banks aren't lending. So if you can't get it there, you're gonna get it there. It's just supply and demand. Also, we have a liquidity issue. This is what happened in 2008. This is what's gonna happen now. Although thanks to Janet over the last year, 2 years, 2 weeks, the amount of liquidity in T-bills, in bonds that have been printed, what they did, like they blew through a half a trillion. I could be off by a few digits in like days. And all of a sudden you look at the US national debt clock, you're like, bull, that just jumped. How are we gonna pay for that? I don't know. Also, reverse repo, the repurchase agreements, it's being flipped. Just in case you wanted to know where on this chart was the last financial crisis, it was right there. Well, it was actually about March, and then nope, that's it, we can't do it. Guys, no matter how you cut this cheese in the financial world, it stinks. And it comes from a hidden secret. The hidden secrets of money, which I've never met anyone that even knows where money comes from. For those of you who are like, I know what money is, it's gold and silver. No, it's not in a debt-based system, it's not. Let me give you one guess. In a debt-based system, what is money? Huh, that's debt. 98% of all money is right here in a bank, where you go to a bank and you say, I want a loan. They don't have any money, but they create $1 trillion. Right out of thin air, fugazi, it doesn't exist. So there is the hidden secrets of money in under 5 seconds. Some other things you should know about when it comes to these non-bank banks. Private credit is now 1.5 trillion. That's a big business. Not just that, the private credit under management have tripled over the past 10 years. These are a lot of assets and a lot of not assets. Actually, unrealized value and dry powder. You got both. Believe it or not, the growth in these non-banks, they're beaten. The shadow banks are beating bank banks. Growth in market-based finance or shadow banks has outpaced banks. See, look, 2020, 2008, look at you grow. Also, thanks to Brent Johnson of Dollar Milkshake Theory, he created that and is another one of his bros. I've had him on the channel and he's tall. I can't believe how... He's a tall guy. I was in Vegas. I was like, Wow, you're a lot taller in person. Sorry, I saw a squirrel. Shadow banks, central banks, and other. Also, something crazy that you probably, maybe you don't know. That's, again, why you subscribe. Your central banks, your Federal Reserve. Tell me that this isn't crazy. I mean, it's crazy that it happens here. But people could go to the Fed. Fed has no money. But they can cut checks all day long. Oh, and just to let you know, the Fed lends, okay, see, teachable moment, they don't spend, even though people are like, oh, the Fed, they spend. They create dollars out of thin air. No, Larry, that would be Janet who has the printing press. I think there's only, what, 1.5 trillion in paper, you say printing press, in the world. There's none of it. It is all glorious debt loans. At some point, all of that, right? All that is, this is what's happening right now behind the scenes, does end. This is non-bank. Okay. Started right here, I guess 1980. All right. This is what they got. If you could just go back right in this zone, right? We could have fixed this stuff. That's when we are on a gold standard-ish. And now, we're on a nothing standard. And soon we're gonna have no standards. Also, breaking news, a banking crisis is looming in China. No, it's here, and it's not just property. Yep, it's there. You need to understand, when it comes to banks failing in China, failing here, is you don't know about it. And I will explain it to you right now. And here, I'll even draw it for you. Here's your bank. And over here is the bank you don't like because everything in there is pink. Right as your bank fails, because it's gonna fail, regulators step in. This is days in advance because they don't have anything. Well, except they have your money, which is in digits. And they say, you know what? This is not a bank failure, you guys. We're just gonna go ahead and move it on to the pink bank. And then lo and behold, alakazam, no bank failures. And then your government will go, all good, we will pay for anything, anything. Tiniest of banks that could be total scams, because we just saw it. They wouldn't even allow it to go down. Remember that too big to fail? Skip that. There was a clause somewhere. Don't think your governments don't have it. They got it on everything. It's like trap doors or back doors, whichever one you want to go through. Maybe it's Christmas, maybe it's your birthday, and you get to go through the back door. But I will tell you, the government has them. Like they have it with this election. And you're like, wait, huh? You really think that people with trillions of dollars aren't going to control this thing? Also, before I delete this article, look at this. Property-related loans are at 40%. Boy, China, you're going to go through some very difficult times. I think we just got a few days left for our most difficult times. Also in China, I didn't mention, there was 40 banks failed. Hello, anyone? Anyone want to report this? Nope, we just merged them all into one. Didn't see anything. Sorry, all my Chinese friends, that you can't get your money, can you? But now let's talk about money and what's going to happen over the next decade. Well, just to let you know, the elites, well, they've already jumped ship. I mean, take a look at what Warren has done. And if you're like, what is he doing? I will show you in just a second, but let me show you some analysts and where you have all your money right now in the stonk market. The reversion will eventually come. Okay, here we come. A chief strategist, which is above an analyst, says Goldman Sachs and JP Morgan are right to warn of weak returns for the S&P 500 over the next decade. Now I have a lot of LA Unified previous students that are like, I don't know decade, okay? Hold up two hands, okay? These are your phalanges. Each one of them is a year. That's scary, right? That's 10 years of weak and no returns. Are you gonna be okay with that? The answer is yes, because as your economics teacher said, time in the market's always better than timing the market, Gerald. And I know what you're thinking. I wish there was like a better way. I mean, why can't I be like Jeff Bezos? Why can't I be shredded and have a hot girlfriend? Did he get married? Do you do it the second time? Now I have to Google it, right? She's hot. Come on. Come on. Dude has a lot of money. And that's on the left hand, and she's pulling a kitty. That confuses me. Why you confuse me, Lauren? Now I have to Google it again. No, Jeff Bezos and Lauren are not married yet. So, hey, Jeff, I have some advice for you. Don't do it. Jeff Bezos plans to sell 16.4 million of shares. This add them up. over $3 billion. But I'm sure it's just for taxes, right? But wait, it gets better. The red guy, Justin Berkshire Hathaway. Also, if you're ever feeling like I gotta send Bravo, also shout out to GoPro something. Hit me up with like a $20 super chat. Oh my gosh. So because of that, I went out and I bought a healthier drink. I don't know, I need an energy drink, guys. Please do not tell me that I'm gonna die from this one too. I actually got emails from the people that work at the companies and they're like, don't drink it. But I'll tell you, I spent all day researching and yeah, this doesn't just magically come out of my boo-ha-ha. And then I start to like dip and I'm like, okay, I gotta film. Give me something. Because I want you to be entertained and happy, and I don't want to be depressing. Anyways, Berg, if you guys got something for me, I'll take it. And no, I don't need crack. Cash pile, three. His pile, I want that pile. 325, 326 billion. Sells another 25%. What could possibly go wrong? They were net sellers in the quarter of 35 billion of shares. First quarter, they didn't buy back their own stock since 2018. What does Warren Buffett know that we don't? And I just say, I think there's some bad things coming. And actually, it's not just Warren and Jeff. It's everyone. Look at this. This is the largest, well, almost. U.S. stocks have seen the, there it is, largest outflow by institutional investors since 2015. But I know, time in the market, always better than time in the market. Well, except for Jeff and Warren. I mean, what are the chances that they're nailing the top? Huh, I wonder. I mean, we kind of are at the top. Quote, the top 10 S&P 500 stocks now account for a record high 30% of the SPX. That would be Microsoft, all the ones that they're selling. Here, let me help you. Berkshire Hathaway, Amazon. See, when they get out, it's probably a good time to get out. Well, I mean, you guys should all get out and get in and get back out again and then get back in again, right? It's just like when you're in college. Ins and outs, but at a high rate of speed. Look at that. This is the S&P 500, SPX. You want to know where it's going to go? I will show you. Also, if you want a deal, it is the election deal. Everything is 50% off. Wait, hold on. Kitty's calling.
Yes, Kitty, what?
I want everyone to have 80% off the courses because they killed Peanut.
Okay, you got it.
Poor 80%. Thing.
Okay, pop the confetti, I guess 80% off whatever you guys want. Start with the swing trade, get to options. You got to learn how to draw these things. Now I have software that can actually, I wonder if, oh, we'll just take a look. Let's see if it picks it up. Hold on one moment. Oh, it was close. All right, I'm going to show you another one. So you guys got, you need to learn how to talk. This is a rising wedge. This is bearish and you don't want to break that. Otherwise, we go down. How much we go down, you want to know. I will draw it for you. From here to here, we're going to carry that. Sorry, I have to be perfect because you call me out. 7, 8, 9, this is where you should be closing a position. This is where you come in. That's where you get out. Come in, get out. Come in, get out. This, we may even have a chance for a swing trade on that. And if you want to know what I am swing trading, bull market watch list. If you want to know what I'm trading that goes down, bear market watch list. If you want to know what I'm trading all around, that would be options watch list. But there is your price target on the S&P 500. But I don't care. I will swing that if we get a beat down and one candle close above the Bravo 9. I move funds. Actually, in my watch list, you guys made a killing on this one, ADMA. You're welcome. And if you're wondering, we're above the reactor, the 200, above the Bravo 9, swing trade, make lots of money. But at the same time, please, oh, that's the bull market. Please be careful. These are the big dark clouds that you're like, is it gonna rain? I don't know. I'm still gonna, you know, still gonna do it. You guys are in cycles. Actually, in one of the cycles, Elliott Wave, I don't know. See, that's like you just gotta wait and see. You can't play. Me, I wanna always be playing. So it's good to know, like, all right. This Elliott Wave, you guys could lose everything. This going back, and I don't have the chart, just it's in my brain. It goes back to the 1800s. You guys are topping on the number 5, and you could see 30 years down. Oh! That's never happened before. Oh, yes, it has. It happens all the time. 10-year cycles, 30-year cycles. But we have such recency bias that markets can only go up forever. This is the Heavy Truck Index. Do you see end of cycle, extreme level? Do you see where we are currently at? Do you see that black line way up there? Well, let me help you here. I'll move around and I'll show it to you. Stock market go down. Heavy, right? The economy go down. Stock market go down. Economy go down. Stock market go down. That was 2007, 2008, right? All right, here we go again. A little bit, right? Down, a little down. Then we're like, wait a minute. Maybe we're okay. Maybe we can print our way out of this. And when I say print our way out, I'm talking about bonds and the Fed. And then Janet has money, throw it into the economy, you pay it back in your taxes. That will work until it doesn't. And they are blasting it right now. Tightening, what kind of tightening? I say you want tightening, tell them to stop doing that. And then you will have, you'll have a lot of tight. You won't even be able to, you couldn't even put a pencil in it. I mean, there is a problem when the government takes in $5. We'll just go with that just to keep it simple. But then they spend 10. Where do they get that other five from? However they do it, they get it from you in your taxes. And they've just been like, everyone, government, more workers. Look at how many government workers we have. This is great. We have a strong economy. No, you don't. This is a gigantic, this is communism. Okay, see, up. Now, what do we got here? Well, you're in the way, Bravo. I shall Casper myself then. So looking at this right here, see? Oh no, it's bad. Oh no, stock market good. And then the question is when? Say, I don't know, but I'm still gonna make money from this. Also, take advantage of today's RIP. Sweet peanut. It's gonna be something like this that just breaks the entire system. And when people look at the system, they're like, so this is our government. Oh, right, you're getting it, aren't you? It will be something as stupid as peanut. No, he's not stupid, sweetie. That just everyone is like, I am done. That's why I'm like, you probably have very little time left. Oh, and just in case you wanted to know who killed Peanut, you're not gonna believe this. Her name's Karen. And boy, that's America right there. It looks very 1930s Germany. I'm gonna go with that, Karen. Also, when I say it's gonna get bad, it's gonna be Tim Walz bad. This is Minneapolis. You would think this is like worn, torn countries in Somalia or who knows what. No, this is the United States of America when the elites are like, no, police, you will do nothing. You will stand down. This thing's gonna get burnt down. What just happened? LA, right? Looting, riots, everything. Crowd sets everything on fire. How many arrests? Zero. They're getting ready. So if you're like, getting ready for what? You tell us what you said. There was going to be a prediction. Okay, here's my prediction. If Trump wins in a landslide, they're not going to let it. Number two, if Trump wins by a little bit, they won't allow it. You see, I'm not giving you who's going to win. I'm just going to tell you what happens after which one wins. I mean, look what they're doing to this guy, that Trump guy that he's running again. For some reason, whoever's pulling the strings, they don't like him at all. I mean, how many times does the cat have to be assassinated? And he got lucky. Peanut, not so lucky. What, three attempts? Come on. Let's see, what else? How about misinformation? I know, as a YouTuber, I get shut down. I can't say a thing. I mean, if it wasn't for X and Elon, we would be dead. And the media is lockstep. I've showed you videos where, you know, your daily news, right? All the daily news across the United States, they're all saying the exact same long base sentences. This is not small. It's like they get sheets. Here's the stories. This is what we follow. Right now, the media is trying everything. They're like, it's Hitler. No, that's who killed Peanut. I mean, they're trying everything against this guy. If you throw imagine having a criminal charge. One, I'll bet you Joe Biden has zero. I'm just going to guess. You know, you know who's doing it? By, I don't know, there's someone dies. Or, I'm sorry, too close to election. Let's say someone gets all the answers right on the test. There's one person that just repeatedly gets everything right. They're probably the one that knows the answers because they stole it. But I'm pretty sure Obama, zero. Harris, zero. Everyone, zero. Trump, 88 criminal charges. I'm pretty sure at the beginning, they're like, okay, this'll do it. And then they're like, That didn't work. Okay, kill him. Well, sir, we missed him by that much. So you really think with all of that, they're going to be like, well, okay, we're just going to give up. No way. Oh, and Trump says if Kamala Harris wins, quote, 3 days away from depression, which I'll show you in just a second. Before we go into depression and economy, let's get some insider. What do we
got? Some bad news for you, and I'm going to give it to you straight. I have sources inside the Kamala Harris operation, and I can tell you this. As of this morning, Kamala Harris and her people are 100% confident. They're not in the least bit worried. They are 100% confident, and they're saying, do not worry about it. Don't worry about the polls. Don't listen to the polls. We have this in the bag.
I know you guys are like, don't listen to him. Just get out and vote. Like, it's all... Okay, I kind of know how the elites work, and you're not going to like it. And they will make your life so miserable that people will give up because they tried it a few years ago, which I was shocked at how Americans just lied down. They're like, okay, what do you want me to do? But they know if they don't get it the way that they always get it, that they will turn up the pain gauge. And America will be like, I just want to go back to normal, whatever it takes. And right now they are currently preparing National Guard troops on standby in Washington State, Oregon, Nevada, California, everywhere. Pretty sure they have it all planned out just like they always do. If it goes this way, we do this. If it goes this way, we do this. And this is how we win in all ways. But now whoever wins, I wouldn't touch this economy with your friend's 12-foot pole. If Kamala wins, I don't even know what they're gonna do. If they just keep lying, or like, okay, you guys, let me be real with you. We've been in a recession for 2 years. I know, and the president's been healthy too. He did lie like once, but then there was a lot in that once thing. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and squirrels, RIP. All right, that's a saying I always have. Now I'm like, now I feel bad using it. United States, you guys want to know your economy? Manufacturing, PMI? Let me help you with this. Going back to the 80s, you don't want to cross underneath that red line or it's like really bad, also known as a recession. Guess where we were at in 2020? A recession. Guess where we have been at? A recession. But they won't say that because then you just can't get reelected and give people lots of money. Just this time it was government people. Also, we hired a lot of government people. I guess that solves everything. Right now, as we speak, no, I mean, for a while, numbers have been coming in and it's bad. Your economy is toilet bowl bad, and I don't know how you're gonna save it. They have basically done everything that they could to fake the numbers, and That's not working. It's like they've used so many drugs just to get over the finish line. I mean, look at Joey B. Perfect example. So many drugs. Get him over the finish line. I don't think so. We're going to have to carry him. Okay, what about that girl? Kamala. Let's put her in. Oh, come on, man. That's what Joey B. would say. Your payrolls, okay? So, oh, it looks great. JB looks like it's perfect. Let me help you with this. Here. It goes down there, and if you want to fill it in, you can. And this is private payrolls in the toilet, which is a little hard to cook. Like the establishment survey payrolls. But they only put on 12. You're like, yeah, but we had volcanoes and hurricanes. It would be bad. And not just that, these are the cooked books. Also, if you are a Chartist, let me help you, okay? The trend is your friend until the end. Let's just hope this all burns down. We can do this thing called austerity rather than the other thing of kick the can. But however they cut this cheese, it's gonna smell, but we're gonna make money from it, right? Do it for peanut this year, that your digits go up and you start a business. Otherwise, peanut's death will be in vain and you'll have to sleep on that. And with that, I love you. I'll see you tomorrow.